The designers say Tejas is a multi-role fighter aircraft. One test variant even had an additional seat, but that only ate into the fuel capacity. Tejas is missile-capable, and once it is airborne can detect and shoot down enemy targets 120 kilometers away, 15 kilometers operational altitude. It can give close air support to the Army. It can do combat air patrol for 6 hours if refueled in air. It can do deep penetration roles day and night and in all weather. It has been tested to operate in Ladakh. It can carry nuclear weapons if necessary. To assess combat capability of an Air Force, sortie rate is a better indicator of the combat capability rather than number of fighter aircraft possessed by the Air Force. An aircraft sortie is defined as one flight of the aircraft for a specific mission. We need a light aircraft with rapid sortie generation capability, which delivers very high load per sortie. With 8 hardpoints and Mirage 2000 type capability, the LCA Tejas fits the bill. Due to its night flying capability, 24 hours operations, and its lightness and maintainability, LCA Tejas can give 2.5 to 3 sorties per day per aircraft for close air support and point air defense roles. With its induction and IAF, a crucial capability has been added, especially against Pakistan. LCA Tejas with its high sortie rate will be a great value adds to scenarios such as Cold Start Doctrine or similar ones. Indian Defense Minister reported 10-year program delay as well as escalating cost. From initial operational clearance, IOC, to final operation clearance, FOC, process is not a time-bound progress, nor there is any set timeline for everyone to follow. Work required to move from IOC 2 to FOC in 2 years for LCA Tejas required addition of a new Python 5 close combat missile and addition of new Derby BVR missiles, new supersonic drop tanks, mid-air refueling system, integration of the gun, flight envelope being extended to 3.5G to plus 8G from the 2G to 6G, angle of attack, AO, also increased to 24 degrees. FOC certification for LCA Tejas MK-1 now has been scheduled for mid-2018 from 2014 originally, but it is also fact that qualification and addition of features and capabilities or replacement of obsolete technology will continue in parallel, and it now seems IAF has also understood this and is now open to working with developers and other various agencies to keep adding additional capabilities to keep the aircraft technically relevant rather than chasing FOC certification. Tejas production hangar reveals the most technologically advanced production line that HAL has ever set up, significantly more high-tech than the Hawk advanced jet trainer line that was established with BAE Systems. With an additional investment of Rs 1,231 crore sanctioned for enhancing capacity, the Tejas line is projected to build 10 fighters in 2018-19. And 16 Tejas Mark-1 as each year from 2019-20 onwards. HAL's plan for expanding Tejas production to 16 fighters per year involves establishing a second assembly line. This has physically replaced the Hawk trainer line that is close to completing delivery of its orders. Outsourcing to private defense firms has been key to achieving HAL's production targets. HAL has created 5 Tier 1 suppliers that each build a part of the Tejas. Each of these Tier 1 suppliers sources components and subassemblies from lower order Tier 2 and Tier 3 suppliers, creating an aerospace industry around the Tejas. It earlier took HAL 19 months to build a Tejas, from start to finish. This is now down to 11 months, and we will be building each Tejas in 9 months by September this year. Indigenous content of the LCA Tejas aircraft is 59.7% by value and 75.5% by numbers. To reduce dependence on foreign companies, out of the 134 imported LRUs, the indigenization of 42 units is under progress. Further efforts are being made by way of indigenization with the objective to reduce the import content progressively. The Tejas MK-1A, for which a prototype, previously designated Tejas MK-1P, was proposed by HAL, is designed to correct many of the existing shortcomings in the FOC standard aircraft. 16 planned to be equipped with an ASA radar and UCAV systems currently missing from the FOC standard Tejas MK.1, The Tejas MK-1A may be the ultimate development of the basic Tejas airframe given its lack of internal volume without necessitating major redesign. Consequently, a radar co-development initiated between HAL and OTA Systems of Israel, understood to be based on Latter's L/M2052A radar. The Defense Ministry even got an unsigned letter alleging that HAL's move to float a global tender to buy an electronic array radar and jamming pods instead of waiting for DRDO's version amounted to wastage of public money. There has been considerable competition between the DRDO and HAL on the project. Besides the MK.1A variant, which should be accorded priority, the two-seat trainer version of the Tejas offers the prospect of emerging into a lead-in fighter trainer, LIFT, in the league of the Korean Ki-T-50 Golden Eagle while retaining the core combat capabilities of its single-seat stablemate. This would fill a gap in the IAF's existing training program, which, while adequately equipped with basic and advanced trainers, is compelled to use two-seat variants of combat aircraft for roles more usefully satisfied by lift. Moreover, HAL would invariably participate in any upgrade of IOC aircraft to FOX standard. There exists a market for fourth-generation battlefield air interdiction/defensive counter-air MRCAs, roughly 160 aircraft, required for replacing the Jaguar/Darin III platforms. This is where the LCA AF Mark-2 ought to come in, weaponized LCA AF Mark-2 at best by 2028. If developmental work commences in 2018. DRDO's LRDE laboratory began developing the UTAMAZUR FCR since 2012, its full-scale model displayed at the Aero India 2017 Expo in Bengaluru last February revealed that a lot more work is required in the area of weight reduction. Unless an environment control system, ECS, is indigenously developed for meeting the AZUR FCR's cooling requirements, additional developmental work will have to be undertaken to integrate the AZUR FCR with an imported ECS. While the DRDO's Bengaluru-based DARE laboratory has already developed the jammer as well as the integrated digital radar warning receivers cum jamming transmitters, that have already been installed on the upgraded Jaguar/Darin III flying prototypes. The AI-designed cockpit for the LCA AF Mark-2, which was unveiled in 2013, has already been deemed as deficient by the IAF, which has since then been showing its preference for the cockpit NG suite that was originally developed by Israel's Elbit Systems and can easily be provided by the Halbit joint venture of Elbit Systems and HAL. In fact, the IAF also prefers the same cockpit NG suite for the F-16 Block 70s that are on offer from Lockheed Martin, and it needs to be noted that Elbit Systems had originally developed the cockpit NG suite for the global F-16 midlife upgrade market, and now even Saab has selected the cockpit NG for its James 39 Gripen S. A revised roadmap dealing with the propulsion system for both the Tejas MK-1A and the LCA AF Mark-2, MRCA, is slowly but gradually emerging, following the satisfactory conclusion of recently held negotiations between India's MOD-owned DRDO and France's Safran Group. If and when it is implemented, it is still awaiting authorization from the Government of India. The Plan 83 Tejas MK-1A will use the GE-supplied F404i and 20 turbofans, and after these engines reach the end of their total technical service lives, TTSL, they will be replaced by a new 98 kilonewtons thrust, with afterburning, turbofan that will use the M88-2 engine's core section supplied off-the-shelf by France's Safran, while up to 60% of the turbofan's components will be derived from those already developed by the DRDO's Bengaluru-based Gas Turbine Research Establishment, GDRE, for the Kaveri turbofan. All these modified components, including second-generation single-crystal turbine blades, will be co-developed with the help of military technical mentoring by Safran. So, for 83 Tejas MK-1A MRCAs, the turbofans to be procured should comprise 83 F404 GEI and 20s, plus 83 of those turbofans that will be co-developed by GTRE and Safran. This, in turn, means that GTRE and Safran will have until 2026 to come up with the definitive turbofan for the commencement of airworthiness-related flight test regime for both the Tejas MK-1A and the LCA AF Mark-2's weaponized prototypes. Initially, however, the LCA AF Mk-2's flying prototypes will be powered by AF414 GEINS6 turbofans.